Welcome to Better Police Reports. I'm Jean Reynolds. Today's topic is interviewing victims. Interviewing victims is an important part of your job as a police officer. Victims can provide important evidence that can help solve a crime or convict a criminal. Often you'll be using information from victims to write your police reports. Talking to victims can be stressful. Victims bring a host of negative and sometimes overwhelming feelings to the interview: fear, rage, helplessness, confusion, and guilt. But you, the officer, have a job to do and a limited time frame to work with. You need to be sensitive to what a victim has been going through while, at the same time, asking questions to obtain the information you need. Today's video is going to offer you some guidelines about conducting an interview with a victim. 1. Acknowledge the victim's feelings first. When the victim feels that you're on their side, they'll feel more comfortable talking to you about what happened. Don't be in such a hurry to get to the facts that you ignore what the victim has been going through. Use a business-like tone, but inspire confidence. For example, you could say, "You're safe now, ma'am," or, "I understand that you've been through a horrible experience." Taking a few moments to build trust and be sensitive can set the stage for an effective interview. 2, don't blame the victim. Your job is to prosecute lawbreakers, not victims. Citizens sometimes complain that law enforcement makes them feel guilty about what happened to them. A rape victim has a nice figure and attractive clothes. A burglarized house had open windows. A car involved in an accident was exceeding the speed limit. Get the facts, but focus your attention on the offender's wrongdoing. 3. Be efficient. Don't extend questioning longer than necessary. Cooperate with other personnel at the scene to ensure that victims aren't asked to go over the same information more than once. Stifle your curiosity and stick only to relevant information. 4. Be fair and professional. It's human nature to like some people better than others. Don't let your feelings affect the interview. Professionals are expected to hold themselves to a high standard of behavior. Avoid showing your disapproval of a victim's lifestyle, values, or beliefs. You're a professional who treats everyone with the same respect and courtesy. 5. Expect some interviews to be challenging. You may interview citizens who are prejudiced or irresponsible. Some may have made lifestyle choices you don't approve of. And it's possible you may have to enforce a law that doesn't make sense to you. Always remember that you're enforcing society's laws, not your own values. Don't let your personal views interfere with an interview. 6. Educate yourself about community resources for victims and offer information when appropriate. Experts say that victims can experience long-term damage to their health and their relationships. As a professional police officer, you can be one of the first to help. Most communities offer services to help victims deal with injuries, emotions, and adjustment to everyday living. Make sure you have the information you need, such as booklets, flyers, and phone numbers. Document any information you share with victims. These guidelines from officers with long experience in talking to victims can go a long way to enhancing your professionalism and the reputation your agency enjoys in your community. Review them often and practice them whenever possible. The benefits are both significant and long-lasting. You can learn more about report writing at yourpoliceright.com. All the resources there are free. And if you're looking for a low-cost, practical book, Criminal Justice Report Writing is available from Amazon.com. view a free sample online. A free instructor's manual is available for instructors and administrators. Send an email from an official account to jreynoldswright@aol.com. And that's it for today. Thanks for watching.